Fred Willard was an improv comedy master whose star shone brightest in the satire of writer-director Christopher Guest, playing a goofball so straight it wasn't always clear he was in on the joke. Willard died Friday evening in Los Angeles of natural causes at 86, his agent Mike Eisenstadt said. In the 1996 film that launched him into the mainstream, Waiting for Guffman, Willard was a small-town amateur actor opposite Catherine O'Hara. With utter sincerity, the duo auditioned in matching tracksuits with a Taster's Choice commercial performed to the 1973 hit song, Midnight at the Oasis. It killed. The film became an instant comedy classic and earned Willard an American Comedy Award nomination and a Screen Actors Guild Award nomination. Fred has the patent on characters who are comfortable in their stupidity, Guest once noted. Born September 18, 1939, Willard cultivated his wisecracking straight man persona as the son of a stern father who worked in a bank. He was raised middle class in Shaker Heights, Ohio, and fell in love with sketch comedy after seeing the 1950s vaudeville silliness of bandleader Spike Jones and the City Slickers. Though Willard spent his formative years in military school, earning a graduate degree in English from Virginia Military Institute, his heart was always in show business. After he spent his stint in the U.S. Army stationed in Germany, he moved to New York in the early 1960s to train as an actor. In no time, he and a classmate were appearing as a comedy duo on The Ed Sullivan Show. Around 1965, Willard moved to Chicago to spend a year training with the groundbreaking improv group, The Second City. Then he returned to New York and co-founded his own troupe, the Ace Trucking Co., which spent years performing on high-profile TV variety shows, opening for Tom Jones in Las Vegas and eventually releasing a comedy album. Along the way, Willard co-starred in an off-Broadway black comedy with a 20-year-old Guest, a connection that would later change the course of his career. I knew something was off when Fred started doing lines that weren't actually in the play to me, Guest said in a TV interview in 2007. I didn't know what to make of it. I said to myself, you're different. By 1977, Willard was appearing with Martin Mull as host of a short-lived parody talk show, Fernwood Tonight, created by Norman Lear. That led to another brief hosting gig for the NBC reality series, Real People. But it was Willard's mastery of the mockumentary, starting with the 1984 film, This Is Spinal Tap, that first earned him widespread notice. In that film, he played an Air Force officer trying to prove his hipster cred with a series of cringe-worthy jokes. And though it was years before the film reached cult status, Willard had discovered his place. He spent the 1980s and 90s bouncing around TV with a few notable recurring parts, including as Mull's gay partner in Roseanne.